The number one men's tennis player in the world is back home in Serbia, and the Australian Open is underway without him. And now his participation in the French Open is in question as well. Scott McLean is live in Belgrade, Serbia for us. Scott, fill us in.
Hey, Anna, yeah, there was a huge swarm of not only press, but also fans who showed up at the airport here in Belgrade to try to catch any kind of glimpse of Novak Djokovic. Now, we were waiting for him at the VIP exit to the airport, but of course, Novak Djokovic isn't a VIP. He is well beyond that in this country. He is a national hero, and that is why perhaps his treatment in Australia has earned near universal condemnation here. The Serbian Olympic Committee called it a huge injustice. The Prime Minister called it scandalous. The President called it a witch hunt, and a lot more than that. Now, Djokovic isn't planning to speak to the press anytime soon, but there's a lot of people who would love to know what's going on in his mind right now, especially on vaccination, because his decision on that will likely determine whether or not he can play in the next Grand Slam, the French Open, and he's the defending champion there. That's because the French sports minister told CNN just today that there will be no exceptions to the French vaccine pass law, which requires people to show proof of vaccination to get into restaurants, cafes, theaters, and sporting venues as well. And that applies not just to the spectators, but also to the athletes. You might remember French President Emmanuel Macron had previously said that he wants to piss off the unvaccinated. Well, I found out today he's also managed to piss off some vaccinated people in Serbia who want to see their homegrown star play, vaccinated or not. Listen.
So that means he can't go to any Grand Slam without a vaccine. I think that's terrible. That's horror. That's horror that's happening to our world, and I think we are going in the future to live with COVID. I think that's his choice, and no one should be forced to be vaccinated. I myself am vaccinated, but I don't think no one should be forced to be.
Now, Australia has framed Novak Djokovic as this kind of anti-vaxxer, but for context, that is certainly not how he is seen here. Right from the man on the street right up until to the Serbian president, most people here will tell you the vaccination is a personal choice, and that's perhaps why Novak Djokovic has said precious little on the topic. So have most of his sponsors, with one notable exception, Lacoste. It tells CNN that it wants to talk to their star ASAP. Anna?
Okay, Scott McLean, thank you for that update. And joining us now is Christine Brennan, CNN sports analyst and sports columnist for USA Today. Christine, the French Open is later this spring. There is still time for Djokovic to get vaccinated. What do you think he'll do?
I think you better get vaccinated, Anna, or he's going to miss a lot of tennis tournaments. What a thing this is. An athlete at the top of his game, in the prime of his career, choosing to not get a shot, or two shots, or three shots, rather than play in the tournaments that he loves the most, that will contribute to his legacy, will be a part of his history, in addition to making a lot of money at those tournaments. And of course, sponsors, Lacoste is not happy, or at least wants to talk to him, because of course they pay to have him play. It is extraordinary that Djokovic, we presume he's vaccinated for polio and other things like this. All these athletes, as you well know, take shots for painkillers, whatever, if they're hurt, and that he would make this decision and take this stand. Wow, what a thing it is. Never thought I'd see it in my career. But yeah, I mean, if he wants to play in the French Open, and when would it presume Wimbledon and the U.S. Open, he needs to get vaccinated. And let's see where he decides to draw the line on his career, his livelihood, everything about his image.
Yeah, you talk about his legacy, his brand. He does have his supporters in all of this, the Serbian government calling his deportation from Australia a scandalous decision. And it is unclear what his sponsors are going to do. As you mentioned, as Scott pointed out, Lacoste saying it's going to review what happened in Australia. I wonder, whose side do you think the broader sports world, specifically the tennis community, is on? Does Djokovic emerge from this a martyr or a villain?
I'm going to pick villain. We certainly know Australia has gone through so much. So just the fact he wanted to saunter on in into Australia, where Melbourne had a 260-day lockdown. I mean, just the arrogance and the cluelessness of this athlete to just think he could just get his way. Most of the top tennis players in the world, men's and women's, as we know, Anna, are vaccinated. So we know where they stand on the vaccine. And I think everyone was just sick and tired of the distraction. Not to say the Australian officials did not make some mistakes or did not elongate this. It was chaos all the way around. But at the end of the day, if you're vaccinated, I think you look at someone who's not vaccinated and who's creating chaos in an event that you love, the Australian Open, and you're wondering what's going on. Another point about the Serbians, of course, they're on his side. But Madison Avenue is not in Serbia. And Madison Avenue is, and of course, sponsors are what pay Djokovic's bills, $30 million in endorsements last year. So, you know, that's where what he has to care about more, the rest of the world, not Serbia.
And as you see Djokovic, you know, be sort of held out as this maybe a litmus test or an example of sorts in terms of the bigger battle at our hands right now. What kind of pivotal moment is this in this time of sports and COVID?
Yeah, well, of course, Beijing, I'm planning to go, and we'll see. Selena was talking about that. We'll see what's going to happen. Clearly, China is this is a real bad turn of events for the Chinese. They wanted to have fans in the stands, and now they'll have government officials, or maybe they'll computer generate fans. But they wanted to distinguish themselves from the Tokyo Games 6 months ago, and now they're going to be much more like those Tokyo Games than the Chinese officials wanted to be. And we'll be watching Aaron Rodgers play this weekend. He's unvaccinated and really the face of the unvaccinated for the National Football League, which is a shame and obviously continues to be a disgrace for him and for the league that someone of this magnitude would lie and mislead and yet still have State Farm and others on his side. So the storyline continues, whether it's overseas or whether it's in the NFL.
Christine Brennan, it's always good to hear your perspective and analysis. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you, Anna.